దిస్ ఇస్ శ్రేయా. వెల్కమ్ బ్యాక్ టు బయోసెఫియాస్ ఛానల్. ప్రజెంట్ మనం ఇక్కడ తన్వీర్ అహ్మద్ వాళ్ళ ఇంట్లో ఉన్నాం. ఇది పటాన్ చెరువు ఏరియా. సో ఈ సార్ ఎన్ని ఇయర్స్ నుంచి టెరెస్ గార్డెనింగ్ చేస్తున్నారు, ఎలా చేస్తున్నారో చూద్దాం. లెట్స్ చెక్ ఇట్ అవుట్. హాయ్ సార్, ప్లీజ్ గివ్ యువర్ ఇంట్రొడక్షన్.
సో ఐఎమ్ తన్వీర్ అహ్మద్, బేసిక్లీ డూయింగ్ టెరెస్ గార్డెనింగ్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ సిన్స్ 8 years నౌ. ఓకే, హియర్ ఐ హ్యావ్ షిఫ్టెడ్ 2 years బ్యాక్ అండ్ దెన్ స్టార్టెడ్ మై టెరెస్ హియర్. బిఫోర్ దట్ ఐ వాస్ డూయింగ్ ఇట్ ఇన్ సన్ సిటీ ఏరియా. సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఐ జనరలీ ఐఎమ్ మోర్ ఇన్ టు ఆర్నమెంటల్ ప్లాంట్స్ అండ్ దెన్ స్టార్టెడ్ వెజిటేబుల్స్ యాజ్ వెల్.
ఓకే, సో యువర్ బెస్ట్ బిల్డ్ ప్లాంట్స్?
సో సక్లెంట్స్ ఆర్ వన్ ఆఫ్ మై కలెక్షన్స్ దట్ ఐ లవ్. Okay. Okay, and all ornamental indoor plants.
So what type of succulents you love?
So I have all my ornamental succulents, you can see here. So, yeah.
Sir, garden lo elanti plants unnaya chuddam, let's check it out.
We have what is this, sunfires, and I think they generally don't have specific names. Okay. But these are moonshine, is there, there's a moon star here. Okay, and this is onion, what we call this is climbing onion, one of the kind of the succulents.
Okay.
And then some other succulents are there. Mm-hmm. Right. These are sedums, color sedums we have.
Mm-hmm. This one?
Yeah, it's here. Sedums okay. are here. Mm-hmm. So these are like almost 3 years old. These are like 3 years old plants.
Okay.
So, and then I'm just growing it here. Mm-hmm. And then I keep sharing all these pups that come out of it. So mm-hmm. with the leaves we can propagate that.
Okay.
Yeah, with so leaves the new, yeah, when the leaves fall down, mm-hmm. they generally pop out as new plants.
Okay.
And then I can give it to people. See here, right? See this? This has a new plant coming in.
Yes.
So this,
like
this
grows.
Yeah. So this grows into a new plant like this.
Okay.
So we do that.
Budding stage.
Yes.
Here is a fish pond. Let's check it out.
Like 2 years back when I shifted here, the first thing I did was I built a pond here.
Okay.
And then I started adding fishes here. Mm-hmm. The main reason is I use the fish water for the plants, so okay. that is actually beneficial for all. This is a grape tree, vine, for which I generally use the fish water, and also roses are good in fish pond water. So I generally use it for a few vegetables here as well.
Mm-hmm.
So all the ground plants, these gets only these water. So I top it up and then after a few weeks I remove that and then add it to the plants. Please come. So these are my orchids. I have a few orchids like it's
okay.
These are dendrobiums, phalaenopsis are there. So again, these grow from the pups. So I generally grow it from the saplings,
okay.
then flowers.
Mm-hmm.
There are some hanging collections, like all hanging varieties I have.
So this is your chill time in evening?
Yes,
chill place
this
in
is
evening
my evening
time.
And morning time. This is my place to okay. have a tea here. Just added this shade for the sun.
Okay.
And these are some of my, again, orchids, which I have tied it to the trees. Because they generally live like that. So they are epiphytic, basically. They don't need
okay.
soil.
Okay.
Similarly, this anthuriums, they don't need soil.
Mm-hmm.
And this is an air plant, which doesn't actually require any roots or anything. It just hangs and absorbs moisture and grows.
Okay. From
air? Yes, that's it. It doesn't need anything, no watering and
mm-hmm.
so on. So these are some of my propagation things that I'm just growing out.
కింద చూసాం, పైన చూద్దాం. లెట్స్ గో.
purely ornamental shade plants which grow in the house. As well as for vegetables, I generally use a lot. Okay, for ornamentals, very few I use them.
You use plants?
Yes. Okay. These are like low light plants I have.
What is in this inside?
This is soil. One is with soil and then one is with some cucurbitaceae. Uh-huh. Don't need water for this. It's been like months I have watered it.
Okay.
Just like it. Low light and doesn't need light also.
It's only like some, it's not totally dark. Just.
Plants. So I have a lot of terrariums in the terrace as well. Okay. I can show you that. Terrarium kind of things, I am growing it in glass cups. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And these again are on, this is fully in water. This is a succulent, which just
this
needs
is in
soil.
Water.
This is in water.
Can I hold it?
Yeah, you can hold it.
Okay. So, you can use terrarium.
And this is kind of a closed terrarium, which we don't open it. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's a sealed for almost now six months sealed.
Okay.
It grows inside with its own air circulation and water circulation.
Okay.
Plants have
this
grown.
This is one of the experiments done by some of the scientists.
Maybe I'm just doing that. So I have a few more closed. This is closed. And due to humidity, it has like moistened up a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Some other smaller terrariums, which doesn't.
What
need.
Kind of terrarium is this?
This is just a petunia plant inside.
Uh-huh.
Okay. And
is this clay or?
This is a clay. And this is a vermiculate clay and a petunia plant. That's it.
What is your work?
So I work in GE basically as a engineering manager.
Okay.
In the firm on the wind turbine engineering.
Mm-hmm.
That is my profession.
So can you give some experiences like something that you have excited about in this plant?
So if you see here, right, these are basically succulents from leaves. I've just started growing them on these bottles. Generally, succulents has to be grown with a well-drained soil mix, but I have tried to do it in a bottle without any drainage.
Okay,
it doesn't drain.
How is
so it's going up very nicely because I use very, you have to be very delicate when using water.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I just give some few drops of water every week.
Okay, only
how,
few drops.
That is how I manage them. So that is how it is going up.
Mm-hmm.
These are some other terrariums. This is again a closed one with live moss.
Okay.
I just recently created this.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And this is a succulent. Just kept
are
it here for natural
light. Experiments, or you know the you know them how to grow.
Yeah.
This is mosses.
Yes.
So that because of this humidity, it will be growing.
It's moist inside, so it keeps rotating its own air and water inside, and it can sustain itself. It's kind of a self-sustained environment.
Mm-hmm.
You don't need watering or air on it. I just kept it here because it's newly done, so I need some lighting to settle down.
Okay.
That's why I kept it here.
Mm-hmm.
So this is growing here. Yeah.
Still experiment is going
on. Those are some succulents at the bottom here.
Okay. So did you add any manure in this year?
Yes, I have added this. The soil has all these manures, mixture of cocoa.
Divine.
So this has cocoa peat compost, and I have added a Himanshu's mix as well, a little bit in the first top layer.
Okay.
At the bottom, it's
Himanshu's mix in a sense manure.
The manure that has been added. At the bottom, it's just pebbles. So after that, I don't need water or anything. It will recirculate for many months.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So you have added all the manure and all the plants which we saw down.
Yeah, I have added. I have actually add it in the soil mix itself and then planted.
Mm-hmm.
Only for vegetables, I add it like every 15 days once to for induced growth.
Okay, how is the product?
This product is good. That's why I've been, I think, almost 1.5 years to 1 year I've been using now. So I've been regularly ordering it from it. Even I've used the soil mixes for vegetables. I think they have a good, I can show you the difference between the normal mix and soil mix.
Yes.
I can show you in the test. Yeah, please come.
సో మనం ఓన్లీ ఇంట్లో పాచ్ చూసాం, ఎప్పుడు టెరెస్కి వెళ్తున్నాం వచ్చేసింది. All of this, you make time or you usually have time?
I do have time. To just see, this is like my propagation area. I do all my succulents are growing here. Those are black tomato saplings, and these are again some saplings are inside this.
Can I open?
Yeah, you can open them. Just seeds are there. Seedlings have been done. That humidity is what is required for the plants to grow.
Okay.
Right, so I just cover it.
So this is.
You have the names there, right? Giladias and yeah, these are all seasonal flowers. Almost all are flowering plants.
Okay. So after just growing up, terminated seedlings, you will just transfer it.
So something like this, it grows.
Okay.
And then I transplant it. Mm. And those are some.
Gelbarium. You do have gelbarium.
Yeah, gelbarium plants. So almost all these plants are grown from seeds, except for the fruits. Again, those are like.
These are varieties of tomatoes.
Yes. So, I think
different varieties of tomatoes.
I think I need to water them.
How many varieties is?
You can just count them. All those are written are like the last, but one, all are tomatoes. Yeah.
Wow, it's 24 varieties. Hey, what are these?
These are some mixed seeds. Sunflower is there, and then balsam, and then some other them, and then some saplings have already. This is balsam. I need to water them. These are some mulberry cuttings and this night queen plant cuttings, so which just propagate for distributing to people. And this is some kind of an experiment I am doing with different soil mixes for succulents.
Mm-hmm.
A same plant with like 8 varieties of soil. So this is perlite, this is cocopeat, this is decomposed granite, this is rocks, cinder, then again this is marble chips, vermiculite. So all these mixed with compost and this mix that I'm using.
Mm-hmm.
So all that I'm just kept it like that to just see which is growing better.
Okay.
All vegetables are soil mixes only. These fruit plants, right?
Okay.
So all these are growing with the entire thing is filled with those mixes.
Mm-hmm. Only soil mix.
Yeah, only soil mix.
Okay.
And yeah, I think we have 5 plants.
So, sir, before using Himanshu sir product, which product you have used?
I have been using only red soil and compost, vermicompost. That is all.
Okay.
So, and other than that, I use kitchen compost a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Predominantly, I use kitchen compost. I am making the compost there. I use compost, but since 1 year, I've been using for the all vegetable plants.
Mm-hmm. Because before it's using Biosafia, which product you have used? Vermicompost, like that.
Compost, yes.
Okay. Only vermicompost. So after using Biosafia's product, how do you feel?
You can see the growth there, right? See the leaf sizes that have grown.
Mm-hmm.
I can show you some leaf sizes which are like, you know, bachli, right? Bachli or Malabar spinach is what you call.
Ah, yeah.
See the size of the leaves. It's just because of the mix. I'm not using anything other than this.
Only Biosafia's product.
Mix.
Okay, only soil mix in that?
Yes, soil mix. And weekly, 15 days once, I'm using that manure.
Mm-hmm.
See the leaf size.
It's very big in compared to one.
That is how. And this brinjal plants are like 2 years old. They are still fruiting because I don't use anything other than the manure.
Okay.
Because it's easy for me, just one manure. Otherwise, I used to put the compost and so on. Now it is just one manure that I keep adding.
Mm-hmm.
And it, these fruit sizes are also growing bigger because of manure.
Okay.
I've been using them because some are red soil. Some are mixed, but the manure, see this manure itself has given this stem thickness. Yeah, this is, I think I showed to Himanshu also on this.
So right. You only use BioSafe product in your garden?
Yes, on for the vegetables I use that. Okay. Because it's natural and organic. Mm-hmm. Because it's edible, I don't want to use any chemicals. Yes. That's the reason I use it. Okay.
For succulents?
For succulents, and succulents we don't need any manure or anything. Mm-hmm. Okay. For flowering I do use, but I do use both mix. Okay. Not necessarily manure, but mm-hmm. Both together. Mm-hmm. See, this has all manure mixed.
So, sir, please show some difference between BioSafia's product and another one.
So, if you see here, right, these are like normal soil without mm-hmm. any mix. I've just kept as an old soil without okay. any manure. Mm-hmm. See the size of the leaves, mm-hmm. and this is the bios mix that I've used. See the difference of the leaves here, okay. right? Even though they have infected with some, but that can be removed. But mm-hmm. see the leaf sizes here. It has been, this is the second harvest basically.
Okay.
So, any leaves that you see in the bigger size, right? Mm-hmm. These okras. So, these are all because of the mix only. The size of the leaf is getting bigger is what I noticed. I had that plants that I showed you there also are like huge ones. Generally they come very small leaves. Mm-hmm. But even this, this is a zucchini plant. Again, zucchinis generally don't have these big leaves. Mm-hmm. It's actually getting a bigger leaves here. Okay. That is what I've seen. See, all this is added recently. So the same mix I have added.
Mm-hmm.
And this is because, see this, this is basically a, what do you call, cosmos.
Okay, okay,
and cosmos is generally that size plant leaf. See the leaves and this leaves.
Small one, but yeah, it have grown a big one.
Because this is, I'm using it along with the vegetables, right? Uh-huh. So it is taking manure. I'm not adding manure on those.
Okay.
There's some of the differences I wanted to show you. Mm-hmm.
Okay. How was the service you have given? I mean, they have given you.
Service is good, right? It's always like quick delivery. Mm-hmm. So almost 1 day, 2 days delivery, and they do it at home.
Oh, yes.
Prices are good for me, at least from my side.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm satisfied with that. So that's the reason I have been using it for almost 1.5 years now.
Okay. Do you have any suggestions for the team?
No, good, doing good job, I would say. Continue doing that.
Thank you. Did you give any suggestions to any of the people, your neighbors or family, about the product
yeah.
you use?
So, yeah, I'm part of a few WhatsApp groups and mm-hmm. I know a lot of friends. I have suggested a lot of people
okay.
to buy that based on my experience.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then they have actually took it from Manchu and used it.
Okay.
So,
how did they feel?
It seems like I've got a feedback of good only. Nobody has complained to me at test because okay. I have recommended to many people.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
and they have started using it. Even they have used the manure and the mix as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, since 2 years you have been using
yes,
BioSafia's product.
Right.
Okay. So, you didn't feel any complaint about the product?
No, not at all. Because I don't see any difficulty in using the product. First mm-hmm. of all, sometimes what happens is when you buy other mixes, right, you have to process it to use it. This mm-hmm. is kind of ready. You just take it and dump it on the soil and it
mm-hmm.
is easy.
That's it.
That no. makes my life easy because so many plants to maintain and I just throw this and go away.
Okay. Yeah. So did you count any time how many pots you have?
Never. No.
Like 100?
No,
roughly.
Don't. See, you can see my empty pots there. That itself could be like 100 plus empty pots are kept that side. So
okay.
it could be more than that.
Mm-hmm.
So at least for ornamental in my room that you have seen, I have like 45 varieties of plants that you have seen there.
Okay.
It's just that indoor variety. So okay. obviously you can count.
Okay.
See those seedlings, right? Okay. These are like sunflower varieties. Nine varieties of sunflowers. You see this, right? These are like sunflower varieties that I have put a seedlings for.
Mm-hmm.
Nine varieties are there.
Mm-hmm.
And there were zinnias, again like 6-7 colors I have put.
Mm-hmm.
So these are just started potting. It's maybe some are damaged because of the rain.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I have covered it. But so now all these nine will get into nine new plants.
Okay.
And you see this dark sunflower, that is a chocolate. I have already a chocolate. That is a red one.
Mm-hmm.
You see a lot there, it's a chocolate
yeah,
sunflower.
This one. Okay. It's chocolate. Chocolate sunflower.
So it's like 9 or 10 varieties of sunflower colors are there.
Okay.
Yeah, and grow. And if you see, all these plants are grown from seeds. The first layer, this
mm-hmm.
layer, and all these.
Mm-hmm.
So then these are my herbs. All this is mint.
Okay.
Call it mentum. This is stevia, which is kind of a sweet tasting,
sweet,
you
yes,
know, right?
Yeah.
And this is biryani plant, what you call.
Okay.
You put it in, it tastes
biryani.
Like basmati.
Uh-huh.
Just taste it, maybe a dry leaf will taste like a basmati rice.
That's right.
This one. Yeah. this one the basmati's flavor.
Okay.
And this is lemongrass.
Okay.
That is
bringgrass. So use this for tea, lemon tea.
Yeah, we use it. It's there in the fish pond, near the fish pond. So okay. We use it during teas as well.
Okay.
This is kesavardhini.
Mm-hmm.
Rosemary.
Mm-hmm.
Bringraj.
So use this in vegetables, like any
flavoring. For dry leaves, we can use it for flavorings.
This is also rosemary.
Yes.
Okay. This smells good.
Yeah, this is like basil, and this is lemon's basil, mint basil, I guess. And then there is one more polo basil somewhere. Sometimes, yeah, there is one that is. You just take a small leaf and
this
taste.
One?
Yeah, try it. Would it taste that? It will taste like a polo.
Bamu, thyme.
Yeah, not thyme. It is a basil, and
basil, okay.
Polo. That okay. Essence will be like you eat a polo.
But it smells like that.
Oh. This is dahlias from last year, so just bulbs have regrown now, rains, so they will start to regrow.
Okay.
So all these are having.
So you also use drip system?
Yes, I have the drip for the entire plant system.
Okay.
So I have a timer system set up and switch it on every day like 4 minutes.
Where is the timer system?
It's on the other side, but and the rains have just stopped it. Otherwise, I even have a sprinkler that I use for misting in the summer.
Okay.
So this is the misting system. I have. Yeah, I can show you. I just collected rainwater because rainwater can be used. Empty pots. Yeah, you see here, right? This is the timer that I have here.
Okay.
So it switches on every. I have a motor here that pumps to the drip.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And it switches on like morning 7:30 to 7:34, just 4 minutes.
Okay.
It waters all the plants.
Mm-hmm.
I use.
So
this
these
is my,
are about 100 of.
Yeah.
Pots here.
Empty pots that I do use for flowering.
Different types of experiments can use.
Yeah. And yeah, it will be a little congested. This tank water is what I use for my.
Okay.
The pineapple is about to fruit.
Okay.
It's again, it takes like 22 months. So it's almost like 18, 15 months
so
over now.
What manure you used in this?
Same, no? This is the one I used. I've added mix.
Soil mix.
Yeah. Manure. So I'm just waiting it. I think it is about to start coming up.
Yes.
It's almost, it takes 22 months is what they tell.
Mm-hmm.
Almost like 15 months over now.
What is this?
This is onion saplings.
Oh.
Onions. So see, this is actually your what do you call amaranth bhaji, right? Chukakura, what you call
right?
So the stem of this is all because of that mix.
That?
Yeah.
My
that,
goodness.
Mix, I've used it here a lot. So the stem, it generally doesn't grow like this.
Yes, it grows very small. This grows
That is one came here. Because it may be an overdose of mix.
Here is also one of the
pineapples. Yeah. This one. Zinnia flower starting, palak is there.
Mm-hmm.
Then some tomatoes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I'm using this plant nutrient supplement only, particularly for the flowering plants.
Okay.
So they give a good bloom for the flowering plants,
mm-hmm.
and then I use it like every 15 days on the flowering plants.
So
yeah, just yesterday I sprinkled this, the packet is over now.
Mm-hmm.
So I have sprinkled it all because after rains, if you sprinkle, the next rains will absorb it.
Yes.
That's the reason I have used it.
Okay. So for a month, how many packets you use, sir?
All the monthly, one packet, this one I use.
Yes,
I use one packet.
Mm-hmm.
And
biosphere
soil mix, I already have. I use the manure. Soil mix is already done, right? So I just have a top up. So just yesterday I got 30 kg is just only for top up.
Mm-hmm.
Manure every 15 days. So I have two bags of manure already.
Okay.
So I use every 15 days.
So in one word, what would you say about Biosecure's product?
As I said, like it is making my life easy, I would say.
Okay.
Yeah, that is one.
So how did the product got introduced to you?
So I'm basically part of some 15 to 16 WhatsApp groups within Hyderabad and India.
Mm-hmm.
So within those groups is what I came to know about this product.
Just speak about Biosecure in 2 to 3 lines.
Okay.
What do you feel when using your product,
Okay.
What did you feel? Like it's not stressful, you just have said that. So what made you like, I can use this, there is no problem with it.
Okay.
So how do you feel?
So I've been using Biosecure products for almost, as I said, like 1.5 years. It's been very easy for me to use it. And then that is the only reason I've been using these products, because plant care takes a lot of time. Okay. It needs a lot of investment and time as well. So Biosecure actually saves my time by using these products. thank you.
So, sir, thank you so much for your valuable time and explaining us all about your beautiful garden.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Biosafia.